And welcome, everybody, to University of Tampa basketball. The women's basketball team getting ready to take on the Rollins Tars in Sunshine State Conference action. The Spartans come in with a 14-7 record, 7-7 overall in the SSC. Rollins is 11-9, 6-8 in the conference. Right now, Tampa in fifth place in the conference all by themselves. Rollins at 6-8 is sitting in seventh place. So both teams jockeying for position as we come down to the final 3 weeks of the season. Hi, everybody. Jack Ike along with DiCarlo DeVoe.
Hey, good afternoon, Jack, and Happy New Year to the Sunshine State Conference faithful. And from my days as a player here, Jack, at University of Tampa, Rollins has always been a tough opponent for both men and women.
And we will find that out today as a women's game coming up now, men's game at 4 o'clock against the Rollins Tars. Let's get right into the starting lineups for today's game. For the Tampa Spartans, they will have number 4, Rachel Warden. And Rachel is a sophomore from Elizabethtown, Kentucky. Number 5 is Karma Jeremy, a 5'8 senior from Orlando, Florida. Number 22, Stasia Titer, 5'8 junior from Orlando, Florida. Number 23, Emily Eschew, a junior from Naperville, Illinois. And number 44, Molly Franson, a junior from Tinley Park, Illinois. The Spartans are coached by Tom Jesse, assistant coach Caitlin Mitrick, and the graduate assistant coach is Elena DiAlfredo. On the other side, we have the Rollins Tars. Starting for them is number 3, Jasmine Stone, a senior from Evans, Georgia. Number 4, Jalen Harrison, a 5'4 sophomore from Orlando, Florida, Colonial High School. Number 10 is Julia Engler. She is a senior from Harmony, Florida. Vernicia Andrews, number 23, is a 5'9 junior from Altamonte Springs, Florida. And number 30 is Carly McClendon, and she is a 6'1 junior from Sanford, Florida. Head coach of the Tars is Glenn Wilkes Jr. Assistant coaches are Eddie Cooler, Sarah Taylor, Tammy Stark, Jessica Phillips, and Courtney Berry. Just about ready to jump it up. Officials for today's game, Daryl Dawkins, Sammy Crawford, and Retha Johnson.
Daryl Dawkins, not Chocolate Thunder.
Not the
thunder.
Same one.
Not the Chocolate same Thunder.
No. No. Karma Jeremy to jump for the Spartans. McClendon gets the tip and tips it over to Vernicia Andrews. We are underway here in Tampa. Rollins in the blue, Spartans in the white. Four 10-minute quarters in women's basketball. Andrews inside, McClendon, the lefty, jump shot, in and out. Rebound, Rachel Warden. Coach Tom Jesse says, we've got to prevent offensive rebounds, and if Rollins gets the ball, they are looking to run as quickly as possible.
Yeah, well, that's a good start for them to get the rebound off that miss. Defensive rebounding is key to any team's success.
Eschew for 3. Oh, and if she gets hot, Emily Eschew is unstoppable. Just before we went on the air, I was telling the Rollins broadcaster, if Emily Eschew is open, she'll shoot and she'll make. And she did shoot and she did make. Harrison with the drive, off, rebounded, ball on the floor. Jeremy tips it around. It does go out of bounds and will stay Rollins' ball.
Unfortunate. Great hustle by the UT women, but they, you know, unfortunately they couldn't corral the rebound, so the possession goes back to Rollins. But great defense, girls, or ladies.
Always had to remember that rule. Girls in high school, women in college.
Right.
Outside the arc is Stone. Dribbling around to Engler. Go inside to Andrews. Trying to post up Jeremy. Skip pass out of bounds. Tampa ball off the turnover.
It was an unselfish play, but the Rollins player at that point was just trying to do just a little too much on the pass, just keep it a little simple. But thank you for giving the ball to Tampa.
Rachel Warden to Stasia Titer. Lobs it, but again, nobody there for Tampa. We hustle back the other way. Engler, the leading scorer on the team, to McClendon. She can't get it up. Just a little too far under the basket. Jeremy to the other end. Pass out to Warden, to Titer. Jeremy says, let's run the offense. Gets a pick from Franson. Eschew, shovel pass. And trying to, again, a little bit too much.
Right, the ball is like a hot potato in both teams' hands right now. So the first team to get control And I hope it's Tampa because we're at home and I'm an alum. We'll see.
Tampa on a two-game winning streak after dropping five in a row. Engler, jump shot, in and out. And it's still 3-0 Tampa.
Good block out. Good block out by the UT.
Everything about the Tampa women's season over the last seven games is tied to Molly Franson. She got hurt at Rollins early in the game. They lost that game and then lost four more.
Wow.
She came back and the team has won the last two. Warden, deep three, nothing but net for the Spartans.
6-0, two field goals. All they need is an extra point.
Andrews looking to drive on Jeremy. She'll find that tough going. Bounce pass, gets away, out of bounds, probably Rollins' ball, yes. Both teams seem to be looking at passes right now that aren't quite there.
The UT women, they've come out 2-for-2 from the three-point arc, so that's a good sign.
And it's been from their two good three-point shooters. Head down drive by Harrison, back out, McClendon. Shot clock doesn't expire before the shot comes off. Spartans rebound, come back the other way. Warden almost loses the ball, corrals it back. Calls out the play, gets a pick from Franson, and they call Franson for throwing a little hip there, I think.
You got to hold your position, young lady.
Molly Franson does have a knee injury, but has chosen to play through it as best she can. She said, it's my last year. She's already had two surgeries on one on each knee previously in her career.
Wow.
Came to Tampa last year and had to sit out. Jeremy with a steal.
Well, you can't question Molly's toughness.
No. Outside to Titer, to Franson. Spartans try to work the arc. Harrison playing tough defense on Warden. Four against four there. Shot clock to 10. Warden, free throw line, comes back out. Franson inside the arc, knocks it down.
And the UT women, they open up 3-for-3 from the field. 8-0.
Couple threes and a nice jumper by Franson.
Very efficient.
We are 4 minutes into the game. Rollins looking for that first basket. Turnaround jumper, McClendon, still won't go. Rebound, Franson. Warden, pick from Franson. Titer. Jeremy, top of the key.
They look a little indecisive right now, so Jeremy's getting them in control. In the post to Franson.
Franson, lefty. Nice left-handed move.
Wow,
huh?
Tough.
10-0 Tampa, four and a half minutes into the game, five and a half left in the quarter.
I'm beginning to wonder if Rollins' coach is going to call a timeout to stop the bleeding because it's gushing right now.
Yeah, you don't want it to get too much more than this. Harrison, no good. Rebound, McClendon. McClendon second on the team in scoring. Actually third at 8.2. Jump shot by Harrison. There's the drought. Took 4 minutes and 58 seconds to knock down that first bucket. 10-2 Tampa. 4 subs waiting to come in at the next dead ball. 3 for Rollins, 1 for Tampa. Titer, jumper, right elbow, left elbow, I should say, missing it. And the rebound to Andrews. Harrison hustles up court. Inside the arc, trying to drive Warden, good D.
Great defense.
Cutting McClendon. Jumper from Engler, and she nets it.
Wow, that's a 3. Lead cut in half, 10-5.
So it took them 5 minutes to score, and within 45 seconds, they have halved the Spartan lead, 10-5.
From the Rollins team that I know, they never go away. You got to beat them.
There's a kick, stays Tampa ball. And it is the under five timeout, so we will take a break as well and tell you about a couple sponsors. Walkabout Australian Cafe and Bakery. South Tampa's newest delight, located at 627 South Howard. Walkabout features authentic meat pies, pastries, Down Under Delights. Open Tuesday through Sunday at 10 a.m. So try us, mates. Walkabout Cafe and Bakery. And Mr. Empanada, the beauty of the empanada is its simplicity. Take any of your favorite foods and imagine them inside a pocket of homemade dough. Cook perfectly until it's golden brown and piping hot. Our empanadas are a culinary treat.
Well, being from the Caribbean, Jack, you know, growing up in the Bahamas.
Am I getting you fired up here?
No, that, well, what we call that is a Jamaican beef patty, but
okay,
they're just smaller.
Okay.
That's it. I mean, we had it's the same thing. That's just like the Latino version.
Yeah.
And then you have the Caribbean.
I chose Rollins because the Spanish Mediterranean architecture is just beautiful. The weather's great. We're in Central Florida. We're right on Lake Virginia, and I couldn't turn any of that down.
Rollins gave me that ability and that foundation that I needed to go into the world, and I think that I wouldn't have got that experience anywhere else.
Right now,
Mr. Empanada with 10 locations around Tampa.
Yeah, I'm surprised they're not nationwide. They're good.
Yeah. Lauren Cody into the lineup for Molly Franson.
Franson got off to a nice start, I guess, with the knee
rest
injuries.
Whenever you can. Yep.
And up for three. Oh, in and out.
Rebound, though, to Jeremy. Cody is a junior from Findlay, Ohio, by way of St. Joseph's College of Indiana.
She's a tall lady.
Franson 6'2", Cody goes in at 6'3".
Wow.
Skip pass to Titer, three on the way. Rolls in and out.
Good shot. Nice patience and nice ball movement by the UT women.
We'll get to the new players into the Rollins lineup. Zero with the ball, Yari Martinez-Toro from Bayamon, Puerto Rico. Number 11 is just shooting as Rachel Jablonski.
Get it out.
Warden to the other way to his shoe. Loses the ball out of bounds. Spartans will keep it. Jablonski is a freshman from Orlando, Florida, Lake Highland Prep. And also into the lineup is number 21, Denise Daniels, a sophomore from Orlando, Florida, Colonial High School.
UT has the score now. They've been on 10 for the past 2 minutes. Let's keep that ball moving and flowing through that hoop, ladies.
Spartans now about 2.5 minutes into since their last basket after taking a 10-0 lead. Shot clock under 10.
Got to drive against that zone.
Tighter to Cody. Four on the shot clock. Jeremy.
There it is.
Not her normal shot. Won't fall. But she had to with two on the shot clock. Hustling up court to Bistro now in the lineup. Bistro is a senior from Jacksonville, Florida. So Glenn Wilkes subbing liberally early in the game. Jeremy with the board. 2:40 to go in the quarter.
A strong board at that.
That's redundant with Karma Jeremy.
Nice move. She couldn't get the finish.
Other end, Bistro drives the lane off Titer, lays it up, won't fall, bounces away into the hands of Daniels. They go to the other side of the court to Jablonski. Martinez-Toro, bounce pass inside, Bistro. And Titer blocks it out of bounds. 19 on the shot clock.
It was unfortunate. The Rollins got the possession there. Two UT players fighting for the ball, and it slipped away from both of them.
Aaliyah Abney coming into the Spartan lineup for Lauren Cody.
The lineup just got a little quicker.
Abney, you will find her maybe the best athlete on the team. Ball inbounded to Jablonski to the corner. Inside, they go to Daniels. Top of the key. Working it around, long jumper on the way by Engler, and she nets a three, and it's 10-8.
Wow.
So the Spartans start with a 10-0 run. Rollins has answered with an 8-0 run.
Wow. She has no conscience when she shoots. Good move.
Titer can't get it to go. Hustling back the other way. Jumper inside the arc, in and out. That was to tie the game. Shoe with the rebound, hustling it up court. The Bradley University transfer.
Push it, young lady. Bradley of Hersey Hawkins.
Yes, you bet. Chet Walker, if you want to go way back.
Yep.
And my uncle. who did not play basketball. But he went there.
Bradley, it's located in Chicago, right?
Peoria.
Peoria, sorry. Illinois.
Just outside, a few hours or so outside. Abney on the run.
I think Anthony Parker also went there.
I'm not sure.
That played in the NBA with the Raptors and several other teams. I think so. Candace Parker's brother.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay. I can have my people look that up if you want.
Okay.
Where'd they go? Spartans will inbound it. 1 minute to go in the first quarter. 25 on the shot clock. Spartans can run about half of it. Jumper inside the lane. Oh, in and out. That's a tough intermediate shot. It's like you just hit at the rim or do you bank it?
It is.
And she chose halfway.
Good
defense. Nice deal by Titer. Quickly finds Jeremy over the timeline.
One-on-one.
Drives the lane. Up and in. And she got fouled.
She got a three the old-fashioned way. Let's go finish it off, young lady. Got one from the stripe.
That stops the scoring drought of almost 5 minutes for Tampa.
I love her name, Karma.
Karma. Instant Karma. She has been a fixture on this team all 4 years. Take a look at the roster, and there's Karma Jeremy from, where's Karma here? Colonial High School. And then Stasia Titer, Colonial High School.
Okay.
Then you go to this roster, and there's Colonial High School. And Colonial High School.
Wow.
Tom Jesse said they were all teammates, and they're all playing Division II college ball. So that must have been a heck of a team, and he said it was.
I know, right? Like a homecoming for them.
Yeah. So he said there's bragging rights.
Two on each side of the ball.
Yep. He said it's not just an ice four battle. It's a Colonial battle.
Amen to that. I tell you this, no disrespect. I love all my teammates, but if I ever got a chance to play against them, I'm trying to win.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. They were your teammates.
Exactly.
They're not your teammates. 28 seconds to go in the quarter. Tampa 12, Rollins 8. Shot caught dark. 20 seconds now. They're just going to pound the dribble. Run it down under 10, then run the offense. Glenn Wilkes says, just wait. He's going to give her the word. Now he says, go.
High pick and roll.
Harrison looking to drive. Spins in the lane. Outside, McClendon. Jumper off the rim, no good. Fights for it. Tipped away by Warden. And the quarter runs out.
First quarter
in the books. Tampa 12, Rollins 8. Women's basketball right here on the Sunshine State Digital Network. And TampaSpartans.tv. Jack Ike, Carlos DiCarlo DeVoe bringing you the game here.
And one thing that this happened several years ago, they were actually the first husband and wife.
Yes.
You know, Tom Jesse and his lovely wife.
This is the University of Tampa. Explore your dreams. Discover your talents. Get ready to invent, innovate, and be a leader. This is the University of Tampa.
It's located downtown at 200 North Tampa, just around the corner from UT. DP Dough delivers cheesy happiness on and around college campuses, including UT. For calzones, wings, and breadsticks, order online at dpdough.com. Open late.
Back to Rollins, as I was mentioning to you before the game, Jack. Rollins has hosted a lot of good players.
Yeah.
But a lot of people don't know, this is a little trivia question, that Tracy McGrady actually attended Rollins while he was a standout all-star player in the NBA for the Orlando Magic.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, because he came straight out of high school.
Okay.
So I guess he was on his path and route to, you know, try and get his degree.
Nice.
Yeah.
So while he was in the NBA, he was taking classes at Rollins? Nice.
Imagine going to class and you have a superstar athlete.
Imagine the coach at Rollins going, oh, if only.
Well, he's right from Auburndale, Florida, which is, you know, a hop, skip, and a jump from Orlando.
Second quarter underway, 12-8 game. Spartans off to an impressive 10-0 start, but Rollins answered just as impressively with an 8-0 run. Jump shot, Daniels off the back of the rim, fighting for it as a shoe, and she gets it.
I'll tell you this, this women's team, they play as an example of their coach, Tom Jesse. He's definitely a fighter of West Virginia fame. And I had the chance when I was here, you know, I'd come and play at lunchtime when I was coaching here as a man's assistant. And I played some lunchtime basketball with Coach Jesse. And I'll tell you this, I mean, you may look at him, but you don't see that fire. He has a lot of fire. And he shows it, and he's a very skilled player.
Huh. Spartans inbound. Tighter, a three from the deep. Airballed it. And they head the other way. Leah now in the lineup for Rollins. Number 22 is Rachel Leah.
Well, Tighter hasn't gotten off to the best
nice
offensive
drive.
Start, but she's been contributing very much on the defensive end.
Daniels with the bucket there, and it's 12-10. Tighter, another jumper inside the arc. This one front of the rim and off. Tighter right now, 0 for 5. She'll get her points, though. Leads his team in scoring.
She just has to, you know, take her time.
Get that first one to fall so you get the feel.
What I would do as a scorer, Jack, is if I open up, like, if I miss my first two shots, I'm getting something going to the basket where I can get fouled or I'm going to make a layup.
Okay.
And psychologically, it does something for you as a scorer.
Just seeing the ball go through, huh?
Amen to that.
A shoe, top of the key. Spins in the lane. Nice.
Nice.
Left-handed in.
Nice.
Emily Eshoo with a great drive, and she has 5 for the Spartans.
Yeah,
hit a 3 to open the game.
She has on her playing shoes today, Jack.
They must have something at the bottom there because she just spun on a dime.
True. Nice athletic play.
14-10, jumper on the way. Nice. Wow. Nice shot there by Leah. Leah, as we mentioned, in the lineup now, and she is a freshman from Williamsburg, Virginia.
They actually have the other Busch Gardens
in
Williamsburg, Virginia.
Yep. Colonial Williamsburg there, too.
Yep.
William and Mary University, my best friend from high school.
Okay.
5-year basketball coach there.
And she's in the
there
books.
There you go. It's like she heard you, huh?
Yep.
You scorers know how to transfer thoughts.
Positive energy.
16-12. 16-12. Tighter leading the Spartans in scoring at 12.7. After that is Karma Jeremy. Driving the lane, 7 on the shot clock. Down to 5. Leah drives, tries to put it up.
Eshoo
stopped the shot, but then Andrews gobbled it up and put it back up and in.
Unfortunately, that was one of the things you mentioned, Rollins' offensive rebounds.
Eshoo gets it to Tighter. Spins in the lane, almost walks. Back to Eshoo. She puts the 3 up. No good.
She shot that kind of moving backwards.
Yeah, she did float.
Rollins with a chance to take the lead with the 3 or tie with the 2. Almost made a turnover.
Harrison to the other side to Daniels. She's going to try to drive on Jeremy. Jeremy slaps it away. Turnaround jump hook. Missed. McClendon rebounds up. Missed. Tipped around. Controlled by Rollins. The lane was open. Turnaround jumper, again no good. Franson back in the lineup, tipped it to Jeremy.
And we're off.
Spartans back to their original starters. And the rebound missed, or the rebound taken anyway by Andrews on the shot by Warden. Spartans started this game 3 of 3. Since then, they are 4 of 16.
I think they need to, you know, stay aggressive and drive that ball to the hoop. That way, if you don't get something, you could, if you don't make the shot, you could possibly get free throws.
Jumper, left elbow, we're tied. Leah comes in and A little bit of instant offense, 4 points now for Rachel Leah.
Yeah, call her the microwave. She's cooking. She's just 2 for 2 off the bench.
Jeremy off a pick from Franson. Bounces into Stider. Oh, Tider missed it. Got her own rebound. Laid it up a little too hard. Laid it over the rim. Ashu looking. Fading away from the elbow. Won't go.
The rim has just, got a mini lid on it for the UT women now.
All of a sudden, yeah. Long three. Off the rim, no good. Rebound up and in. And Rollins has taken the lead on the basket by Andrews. And it's 18-16 with 4:16 to go in the second quarter.
That's a big psychological lift for the Rollins Tars. And UT has to answer back very quickly, because playing at home, you want to make sure you control the tempo. You don't want to give the away team too much comfort in your home.
18-16, Spartans now trailing. A couple sponsors giving you these games. Rebuilt Meals, whether you're a competitive athlete wanting to tone up or just love flavorful, healthy food, our meals are built to feed your body with the proper nutrients that will fuel your active lifestyle. Enjoy fitness-inspired meal plans with Rebuilt Meals. Visit RebuiltMeals.com. And Clean Eats, a new cafe located at 3838 Neptune Avenue. It's open till 7. It's not a diet, it's a lifestyle, featuring healthy sandwiches, wraps, bowls, and smoothies. The place to go is Clean Eats. So since the Spartans took a 10-0 lead 5 minutes into this game, they've been outscored 18-6 over the last 11 minutes.
And as I said, Rollins is not known for laying down. You have to beat them. I mean, I've had some good games against them, some wins, some losses, but they're a very well coached team on the men's and women's parts.
Rollins averages 67 points a game. The Spartans average 62 points a game. Both pretty good defensive teams. The Spartans best in the conference at giving up only 55.5 a game. A little full court pressure by Glenn Wilkes this time for his Rollins Tars. Jeremy glides over the timeline. Pass inside to Jeremy. Bounces it out to Franson, but kicked by McClendon. Spartans will inbound.
The pressure sometimes, Jack, it's just there as an illusion. They didn't really try to trap or anything, but if you make a mistake, they will capitalize.
Inbound to Franson. Outside to Aaliyah Abney. She drives. Ashu, three. There you go. All right.
And that's why she was calling for it.
Yep. What you've noticed with Emily Ashu, she'll hit it if you give her the spot. She missed the last couple, but she was contested. Knocks that one down, and Ashu with eight. And the Spartans back into a one-point lead. Long three. Bistro missing. Rebound and a collision out on the around the free throw line. I think Ashu will get with the foul.
That's just unfortunate. She kind of overran the rebound a little bit and just made an attempt at it. It was inadvertent, but nevertheless.
She and Engler just sort of collided.
Yeah.
First foul on Tampa this quarter. Again, in women's basketball, 4 quarters, but also you get 5 fouls. On the fifth foul, you're shooting 2. There's no 1-1. And then every quarter, you reset the fouls.
I like the format. Mm-hmm. I hope the man adopt it also.
Well, what's interesting is you get 4 last-second shots. It kind of adds a little drama to it. Last-second possessions. Turnaround in the lane by Engler. No good. Ashu back the other way. Quickly up court to Warden. Franson outside the arc. Finds Abney. Back out to Ashu. 10 now on the shot clock. Warden lobs it into, and there's going to be a foul.
Right, good play.
Foul on Engler.
Way to find the mismatch, Tampa women. Now, Engler, I'll tell you this. She looks like she's about 15, 16, but she has that Ronda Rousey kind of scowl. She's aggressive.
New shot clock for Tampa. Skip pass, going up to get it was a shoe. Bounce
pass.
Franson. Maybe had the layup, but passed it up. Warden a little out of control with that one.
Little too unselfish.
Yeah. We come back the other way. Martinez Toro, no good.
Watch it back, Jeremy. All the way, coast to coast. Ooh.
Fighting for the, somehow she comes out of the pack with that. Never gave up on it.
After getting a shot blocked, right? Yeah, she's not one to whine. She fights, she's a fighter.
Abney, again, skip past the Warden. Abney, top of the key, looking, a little bit of a runner and hits it.
She moves her feet, Abney.
Yes. Tampa 21-18 on the Aaliyah Abney basket. McClendon.
Got to get a stop.
Hands it to Engler. Looking to go inside, can't. Stone outside the arc. There she goes inside to McClendon. Turnaround jumper and in. She can match Molly Franson inch for inch.
Yeah, that was a nice turnaround jump shot. And it didn't look like luck either.
No. In fact, she'd practiced that one a few times. Abney. A shoe now, top of the key. Seven on the shot clock. Warden with the ball. Lobs it into Jeremy. Three on the shot clock. Nice little inside move and in.
Jeremy's like a female Charles Barkley down there.
She is. It was unfortunate last year without Franson or Cody that Karma Jeremy was the post player, and she is so much more versatile. You're right.
Yep.
Bistro with the push.
She led with her off arm, which was her right arm.
You know, Jeremy had to play the post last year, and she's so much more effective not having to guard the other team's center.
Right.
And if you can put a bigger person in on the post, Jeremy's that much more effective against a player her size.
What Jeremy is, she's like that big guard that, you know, she can pull a big person out, but she'll also post that smaller guard. Kick out.
In and out. 34 seconds left until half. They will have to shoot. About a 3-second difference. Nice drive and a foul called on Cody. Stone will go to the free throw line.
I don't want to question the officials, but I didn't see it down low, but a shoe gets the foul, unfortunately.
Second foul on Emily.
Yeah, that's what being aggressive does, though.
Stone knocks it down, her first of the day. 23-21. Misses that one, fight for it. And taken away by Rollins will get the last second shot. No, Abney with the steal.
Ooh.
Behind the back dribble. Nice move there. And
the Tampa women will hold for one shot.
15 seconds now. Tom Jesse calls it out. Wants Warden to run the point. 10 seconds now. Five. A shoe to Warden. Three. Back to a shoe. Going to have to fire it. It's on the way.
And it's
short. And no good. We have reached halftime of a very competitive basketball game with Tampa leading Rollins 23-21. Tampa shooting 37%, Rollins at 28%. And we're going to take a quick timeout and get Associate Head Coach Justin Pekka in to talk to us, as we've got a men's game coming up. Men's game coming up about 4 o'clock. How's it going, Coach?
Wow, what an honor to wear the same headphones as DeCarlo DeVoe.
Sitting in the same
chair.
Oh,
my goodness.
Same headphones.
What an honor. How are you?
You ever play pickup basketball against him?
We've had some battles in horse. We call it something else, but we've had some battles over the days, over our time. But I think I've got him a time or two.
Keep him humble, huh?
He's pretty competitive, though. He's tough to beat.
Yeah. First question, how's Coach Schmidt doing?
He's doing much better. He's been at practice the last couple days.
Okay.
Feeling better, getting after it, back to his usual self.
So all right, all
he's
right.
He's good to go.
Coach missed the last game Wednesday night with you weren't really sure. He was sick.
Some kind of stomach bug, we think.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know if it's something he ate, but.
Good to see him back.
He's better.
Tough game on Wednesday night.
Yeah, it's tough.
Gets
tougher today. We battled on Wednesday, though. We played better. We had six turnovers compared to our, 20 the last couple of games. So we took care of the ball and did pretty good on the boards. We got back on defense. So we were satisfied with our effort, which was good. Obviously, we didn't like the outcome, but, sometimes the ball doesn't go in.
So you were thrown into the coaching chair, the head coaching chair. What was that like? We noticed you stood up a lot more. You stand up a lot, but you were roaming the sidelines.
That was very nice.
Yeah.
I like to get up, and I think the guys feed off that a little bit. It was a change. It was different, obviously, but I give a lot of credit to the guys. You know, they responded and really helped me in practice, get ready the day before, and that definitely made the transition easier.
So you're taking on Rollins, team at the top of the conference, so obviously the competition, it's always good in this conference, but probably goes up a little bit.
Yeah, it's a tough game. Last time we played them over there, we lost at the buzzer. Duke got hurt 2 minutes into the game, so we were without him, and we still battled and hung in and really should have won the game. We had a mental lapse on defense in the last play. So.
Three-pointer at the buzzer.
Yeah.
Yeah. Going to Rollins was not a good trip for either the men's or women's team. That's when Molly Franson got hurt.
We need to knock on wood.
You're home now. You're home now.
Yeah.
Change of venue is going to be a big difference.
Hopefully.
But, we got Duke back, and he played well, got his double-double last game.
Yeah, 20 rebounds. He had a monster game.
Yeah.
We just couldn't buy a bucket. We were 18% from three, so tough to win when they're playing zone and you shoot 18% from three.
And what can you do? If you don't make it, you can't really.
Shooting contest, really.
Yeah.
Today will be the same. They play a ton of zone, so hopefully we can put the ball in the basket today. We've done a lot of shooting the last couple of days.
Okay.
Put in some new wrinkles on offense, so hopefully we'll get some better shots.
I ran into Nick Marajan at the baseball game last night, and he said he's feeling better, but was telling me about how he really couldn't move for about 3 or 4 days.
Yeah, he's been out of commission for a while. He's starting to look like himself again.
Okay.
He's still come off the bench, but he'll hopefully get some minutes today. We'll need him.
What kind of a style of play do we expect from Rollins?
Rollins actually runs a similar offense to us in the half court. They're going to play tough defense. They play a couple different zone defenses. So it'll be an outside game probably for us with a lot of long rebounds. But there are a lot of pick and roll stuff in the half court.
Okay.
They can all really shoot. So it'll be a tough game. Always is.
I mean, shooting is just can be a day-to-day thing. You guys may come out smoking in this game.
I know. You never know.
Yeah.
We hope.
Yeah.
We hope. We need it to go in. We need to start putting some wins together, that's for sure.
We did ask them. The game on Wednesday goes on coach's coaching record.
Oh, it does? That's good.
Thought we were going to lobby it the other way. It had been a W.
If we had won, I might have fought.
You might have been lobbying.
Yeah. I just wish we got the W.
Yeah, no doubt about that. Well, Coach, good luck in the game.
Thank
4
you
o'clock.
Very much.
Think of me at about 8 o'clock tonight when I'm over doing a baseball game.
You got a long day ahead.
I do.
It's a big day on campus.
Softball's
playing now.
Going on.
Women, then us, then baseball.
Tennis is going on. Yeah. Find any athletic venue on campus today. There's something going on more than likely.
Yeah, lacrosse too, I think.
I think so.
Yeah.
I think so.
Go Spartans. Big day.
All right. Associate head coach Justin Peckham. Men's game coming up about 4 o'clock, so stay tuned. We're going to take a break and come back just before the start of the second half. 23-21, Tampa leading Rollins at halftime of the women's game. You're watching right here on TampaSpartans.tv. And welcome back courtside as the University of Tampa women's basketball team leads Rollins at half, 23-21 the score, about a minute to go before we start the half. Recap of the scoring, Tampa is shooting 37% on 10 of 27 right now. Aaliyah Abney with two, Rachel Warden with three. Stasia Titer has 2 points. Emily Ashu leading all scorers on the Spartan team with eight. Karma Jeremy with four, and Molly Franson with four. Spartans, as I said, 10 of 27 from the floor, 3 of 11 from three, and 0 for 1 on the free throw line. Spartans have 16 rebounds today. On the other side, the 21 points for Rollins coming on 9 of 32 shooting, 1 point for Stone, 2 points for Daniels, 4 for Andrews, 2 for Harrison, 6 for Engler, their top scorer, 4 for Leah, and 2 for McClendon. They are 28% from the floor, 2 of 5 from three-point range, 1 of 2 from the free throw line. They have 23 rebounds in the game, and DiCarlo, as we mentioned, watch them on the offensive boards. They have 8 offensive boards of their 23 rebounds.
Yeah, they scrap and they fight, man. They really get after it, these Rollins women.
And we are underway. Rollins in the blue, Tampa in the white.
Earlier on today, to train Coach Jesse's daughter, and if she pursues basketball, she's going to be like mother like daughter or like father like daughter, because she has the dimensions to become a great player.
Been hanging around dad all the time here.
Oh, yeah. She loves the sport herself.
Yeah.
You know, they don't push it on her.
I bring my daughter to games, and she would rather play with her iPad. She likes hanging out with dad, but she just says, tell me when it's over.
Yeah, we're in that tech era. Back in the day, it would have been Lego.
Yeah. Crayons, something right. Like to get the box of 64s. A shoe, free throw line jumper, no good.
Tampa nursing a two-point lead. Rollins can take the lead with the three or tie it with the two.
Missed shot, tapped up and down. McClendon deals, foul called on the pass.
Once again, I think this is the third time it's happened this game, Jack. Two Tampa players are fighting for that ball, and it gets away from both of them and goes to a Rollins player.
Free throw is good. Biggest lead of the game for Rollins was a two-point lead with 4:20 to go in the half. I believe it was 20-18.
And then UT erased that with a three by a shoe to go up 19-18.
But now we're tied.
Once again.
Actually, it was 18-16 was the two-point lead. Spartans' biggest lead, 10. It was 10-0. Jeremy comes to the free throw line, spins in the lane, puts it off the glass, foul.
She is tough.
Yes.
She is tough.
She will go to the free throw line.
I don't know what she's going to do after she's done here at UT, but whatever she does, taking that type of intensity and passion and work ethic into it, she's going to be successful.
Not a great free throw shooter, though, just 57% on the year. Normally reluctant to take any shot more than 10, 12 feet from the basket. And got that one. Oh, deadened that ball.
Wow. That's what you call playing at home.
24-23, Tampa by one. Engler. Yes, cut off by Jeremy.
Yep, you got to stay on English because she's going to let it fly.
McClendon will too, though, and wow. She knocks that down. 4 points now for McClendon.
And Rollins goes up by one.
McClendon averaging 8.2. Engler 13-3. And Denise Daniels.
Yes.
Molly Franson knocks it down. Big smile on her face as she hits that one.
Good golly, Miss Molly. Great shot.
26-25, Tampa. Franson now with 6 points. Long three. Engler airballed it.
I told you she has no conscience. She's going to shoot wherever she catches the ball.
Problem is she put up a 15-footer from 18 feet away, though.
Well, it benefits the Spartans, so I'm good with it.
I shot a few of those in my career. Franson again near the top of the key. Finds it cutting his shoe, but a lot of congestion in the lane.
I think that's a too little too late on the pass.
Harrison looks to drive.
She's a nifty little ball handler.
That Harrison is. Yes, she has it, yeah. Jeremy with the steal. Jeremy got fouled.
That's the one time you wish the referee didn't call a foul. When you have the advantage going the other way, right?
Yep. Alas, Tampa has the ball. 26-25. 3 minutes gone here in the third quarter. Tighter with the fake and fouled on the way in by Martinez Toro. I take that back. The foul was on number three, Stone. Franson in the lane, dishes out to his shoe. Zone defense now from Rollins. Tighter drives, kicks it out. Warden looking at the three, finds a shoe. She's got time, sets, shoots, hits.
She was calling for that ball for about 10 seconds, Jack.
You were calling for them to get her the ball for about 10 seconds.
Because I saw it.
You stood up and pointed. They finally figured it out. Harrison deep. Oh, she rolls it in. 29-28.
I thought the bank was closed, but I guess she has her ATM card.
Yeah. Automatic withdrawal.
Amen.
29-28. Franson. She has a retaliation shot there. And Molly Franson having a nice game now with eight.
And this is a nice exchange.
Yeah. Teams have come out hot this half. The lead is three, under 6 minutes to go in the third quarter, early second half. Back up top to Harrison. Launching a three, off the glass, no good. This time, the bank rejected it.
Yep.
Quick pass to Titer, can she put it up? No, but fouled by Harrison.
Good recovery by the Rollins player, but she didn't recover well enough.
Well, if she wouldn't have fouled, might have been an easy layup, so take her chance. But that is the fourth team foul on Rollins this half. You shoot two after the fifth of each quarter.
With Tyler being a scorer, this is a great opportunity. Get into that line, sinking a free throw or two, and seeing that ball go through that net.
She made that. That's just her third point. Into the Rollins lineup is Denise Daniels, second leading scorer on the team. Former teammate of Stasia Titer and Karma Jeremy. Also into the lineup, number 20, is Joe Bistro, the senior from Jacksonville. Spartans by five. Have not had a five-point lead since 10-5. Nice jumper by Daniels at the other end. She has four now, and the lead is back to three.
This Rollins team is not going to go away, Jack.
Nope. Franson looking to drive, cut off by Daniels. Ashu way up top. Shot clock to 10. Jeremy, free throw line jumper. Knocks it down. Nice job, Karma. That's her seventh.
And well within her range, like you said.
7 points, eight rebounds for Karma Jeremy.
She's working on a double-double.
Yep. Daniels drives the lane, knocked away by Franson. Foul called on Franson.
Yeah, she has the quickness factor over Franson. The little head and shoulder fake. She showed the ball, and when Franson reacted, she tried to drive by. But I think it was actually a strategic foul by Franson.
It's a good foul, just a second on Molly. Timeout, as this is the under five timeout of each quarter. And we have the Courtyard by Marriott, Simply Refreshing, located at 3805 West.
Hey,
I chose Rollins because the Spanish Mediterranean architecture is just beautiful. The weather's great. We're in central Florida. We're right on Lake Virginia, and I couldn't turn any of that down.
Rollins gave me that ability and that foundation that I needed to go into the world. And I think that I wouldn't have got that experience anywhere else.
Legacy Production Group, not limited to the nightlife. They also have charity and corporate events for many organizations. Legacy Production Group, operated by a proud UT alum.
Wow. That's a nice name, Legacy.
Legacy.
Legacy Production Group. LPG.
35-30, Tampa up, 4:29 to go in the third quarter. Spartans will send out their original five starters. Led by Emily Ashu with 11, Karma Jeremy with 7, and Molly Franson with 8.
Call it a band of the hand, 5 working together.
Engler off the inbound. Yep. Set play, knocks it down.
Oh, don't worry if she misses. She's going to keep shooting.
She has 11, 35-33. Scoring honors for Rollins. Ashu up top, goes good. Inside to Jeremy, posts up, kicks to Franson, inside the arc, shot missed.
I wanted Jeremy to shoot that. She had Engler on her. Yep. All she had to do was reverse back to her right side. She bailed her out that time.
Outside the arc, hands off to Engler, closely guarded by Ashu.
Both of those ladies, if they have an inch, they're going to let the ball fly.
They are leading their respective teams, each with 11 points. Off a pick, Engler trying to drive on Jeremy and fouled by Jeremy.
That's what being aggressive does. It makes things happen.
That'll be foul number. Let's check on that for Jeremy. Foul number 3. Nope, foul 2.
No one for the UT women are really in foul trouble.
Not yet. Well, Ashu has 3, but until she gets that 4th. Engler bounces around. No good. Nice box out by Ashu.
Great box out.
Tighter to the other end. Looks to drive the lane. Turn around. Won't get it above the rim. Got it. Rebound, though. Gets a new shot clock.
She's struggling today at the offensive end, but nevertheless, she's making up for it with her heady play
right
on the defensive end and her hustle.
4 rebounds.
I've seen a lot of players hang their heads when they miss shots. But she's staying aggressive.
Yep.
She's staying confident.
That one won't fall. We come to the other one. Harrison on a drive on Warden. Off the glass, too far, but a foul called.
Rollins with a chance to tie it up at the line.
Into the Spartan lineup is number 3, Julia Ingram, a freshman from Palm Harbor University High School. School my daughter will go to in a couple years.
Okay.
Julia, the leading scorer in Pinellas County last year.
Wow.
For getting more playing time for the Spartans over the last few games, and Coach Tom Jesse said she deserves it.
And in this Pinellas and Hillsborough counties, we've had a lot of great athletes, so to be able to say that is saying a lot. I'm surprised Eckerd didn't get her.
Couple free throws by Harrison.
But that just goes to show you.
Martinez Toro in, game tied 35. Spartans have not scored in 2 minutes. Karma Jeremy has to call a timeout on the inbound.
Timeout. Now there are a lot of recruiting wars that go on here locally on the high school level. And anytime, we can take a player from over there near Eckerd and Pinellas County, whether it's UT men or women, that's a moral victory in itself.
Yeah. All right, we have some other great sponsors bringing you these games. Stay at Crown Plaza Hotels and Resorts. The Crown Plaza is the place to meet.
This is the University of Tampa. Explore your dreams. Discover your talents. Get ready to invent, innovate, and be a leader. This is the University of Tampa.
Not far from here at 222 South Dale Mabry. Spartans, this is game three of a four-game homestand. Florida Tech comes here on Wednesday night to end the homestand. Then after that, just one more home game.
Then we see where they are in the conference rankings and, you know, off to trying to make it to the NCAA playoff.
Eight teams make the conference tournament. Spartans were sitting atop the conference standings until, as we mentioned, that injury to Molly Franson derailed their title hopes. But with Molly back in the lineup, they've become a better basketball team again.
It's all about the timing of when you heat up.
Jeremy,
and one,
up and in,
and
goes
one
to the line.
Way to break the tie.
37-35, nine now for Karma Jeremy.
Good karma always happens when the ball is in her hands.
Knocks
the
it
old
down.
Fashioned way.
Make it a 10 points for Karma. Second Spartan in double figures. The lead is 3, 38-35. Daniels.
She traveled.
And she traveled. Jeremy heartily agreeing with the call.
She came to play today.
Warden across the timeline. Julia Ingram, bounce pass into Jeremy.
Ooh,
a little move on Daniel,
the post,
off the glass and in. She's got a, you know, the Spartans have an amazing knack to make the left-handed shot. They love to drive the lane to the left and get the layup. Back to a five-point lead. Daniels inside the arc. Long three on the way by Bistro, in and out.
Wow.
The shoe with the board.
Tough break for Rollins, but good break for Tampa.
Warden quickly to the other end. Warden, one of two players to have played every minute of this game. The other one being a shoe. Jeremy to Ingram. Three, short. Fighting for it is Aaliyah Abney. Up, no good. Ball on the ground. She gets her own rebound and fouled.
That's what hustle does, Jack, and makes good things happen.
She will go to the line as more than five fouls now. All two-shot fouls for the last minute 18 of the quarter.
What the Tampa women have to do is stay aggressive. They have to stay aggressive. Playing at home, I mean, stay aggressive. Keep that pressure on the Rollins women.
Abney knocks it down. She is a 66% free throw shooter. Molly Franson in, Julia Ingram out. Lead is six. For Aaliyah Abney, now 3 points on the day. That one lips out. Lead stays six. Outside the arc, Bistro to McClendon. Jump shot, nothing but net for Andrews.
She looked like she didn't want to shoot it, and then she's like, I'm open, so let
Might
me
well.
Shoot it.
If you're going to do that, I'm going to take it. Warden, bounce pass. Franson back to Warden. Inside to Jeremy.
Spin back to the right. Yes, yes,
oh,
young
nice
lady.
Nice job by Karma Jeremy. Little shoulder, hip,
yep.
And hip. Gave her a little space.
Can't get around that body. She scored like eight consecutive
points.
She's
on a run here for the Spartans, I know that. 14 points now.
She's hit her last, what, three or four shots?
Layup by Jeremy. Then there was a, let's see what we've got here. Free throw by Abney. The baskets have all been Karma Jeremy's. She has gotten hot for Tampa at the right time. 43-37, 23 seconds to go until the end of the third quarter. Spartans led by two at the half and have upped it to six. But we have 10 more minutes to go after this. Letting the clock run down is Harrison. 12 now on the shot on the game clock. No shot clock on this possession. Seven, long three.
Oh,
nothing
wow.
But net for Stone. And the lead is to three. 1 second to go. They don't get a shot off. Big three by Stone.
Huge.
And Tom Jesse doesn't like the fact that Emily Ashu lost her player. Stone knocked it down, but that was a deep three no matter what. So at the end of three, it is Tampa 43, Rollins 40. You're watching this game on TampaSpartans.tv. Some other great sponsors. And the Godfrey Hotel, formerly the Bay Harbor Hotel, is located at 7700 West Courtney Campbell Causeway. It's right in Tampa, offers a special rate to all UT supporters and guests. The Godfrey Hotel and Cabanas on the Courtney Campbell Causeway. Men's basketball coming up at four.
And Rollins is leading the conference.
Leading the conference.
So this is going to be, this is one of those games, if the UT man can muster up a win today, it can take them on an emotional high in which they can carry on over into the last few games of this conference and maybe make a run in the tournament should they qualify. They have to win today.
Yep. Tampa will inbound to start the quarter. Jeremy to Abney. We are underway. Final 10 minutes. The lead just three.
Rollins applying some pressure.
Staying in his zone but willing to come out and get the Spartans. To the corner to Warden. Looked at a three, passed it up. Abney, 10 on the shot clock. Jeremy looks to drive, goes inside to Franson. Nice pass. Molly can't get it to fall.
Oh, wow. Tough break. She stumbled on the catch a little, lost her footing.
The lead is three for Tampa. Rollins with the ball. Stone outside. Looking to drive the baseline, cut off was Leah. Again, Leah looking baseline, looking to go inside. Three on the shot clock. I don't know if she notices. I don't think they're going to get a shot. They do not. Shot clock violation.
Good defense for a full 30 seconds by the Tampa women.
First shot clock violation of the game. We come back the other way. Karma Jeremy up top goes to his shoe. Rollins staying in the zone. Warden with a three.
Oh, wow. Big shot. Big
Rachel
shot.
Rachel Warden now has six. Drains that three, and it's 46-40. Stone to Engler. To Harrison. Harrison a quick three.
Oh, wow. Right back at
you. He has the answer. 46-43 for Harrison. Point number 10 on the day. Harrison averaging 8 points a game, so just a little over her average already. Ashu to Abney.
Look for Ashu.
Back to Ashu. Looked at it, but they came out quickly. Abney, nice drive down the lane. Won't fall, though.
kind of lost the handle on the ball as she was going up a little, but she got a good shot up, but just didn't fall.
3-point lead for Tampa. Stone with the ball for Rollins.
A thrill tie and a two cuts the lead to one.
Pass inside,
good
deflected
defense
by Abney.
Good defense.
And Jeremy has it for Tampa. She does a little traffic directing.
Get it to the corner.
Yeah. Ashu had the shot.
Too late.
Tried to force it inside. Wasn't there. Skipped over to
skip pass.
Warden. Warden
skip
may
pass.
Look open, but McClendon, who is 6'1", closed on her.
Oh, wow.
But Franson knocks it down.
This lady Franson is for real, man.
She'll hit inside and she'll hit outside. She's got 10.
She has a nice shot.
Third Spartan in double digits. 5-point lead, 7 minutes to go. Andrews drives, fouled by Jeremy.
That's going to be number three on Jeremy.
First foul of the quarter for either team. Third foul on Jeremy. And to the line goes Andrews with 6 points on the day. Her first trip to the line, though. Hits it. She's put together a good game. 7 points, 8 rebounds. McClendon with 7 rebounds. Daniels with 7 rebounds. Karma Jeremy leading Tampa with 8. Ashu has pulled down 4. And Titer with 4.
Yeah, her 8 rebounds has been very quiet, but she has 8.
Full court pressure. Warden had a little trouble. Ball goes out of bounds. It will be still Tampa's ball. 2 seconds ran off the shot clock. And again, some backcourt
watch
pressure.
Out for the trap.
Don't get trapped.
Get the ball in the middle.
Finds Jeremy. Quickly
reverse
across. And the shoe lost the handle, and it goes out of bounds.
That's what the pressure does. It makes you rush. And something that's routine, you just don't do it as routinely.
That is only the 6th turnover of the game by Tampa. Very clean game by both teams. Stone. They go inside to Andrews. She looks, turns around in the lane, banks
oh, wow.
it home. Julia McClure, or Julia Ingram back in the lineup for Tampa. Giving Stasia Titer a rest.
Andrews with her 10th point. She moves into double figures.
Franson bounces it into Jeremy. And she just muscles
oh, wow.
her way in off of Andrews.
Like I said, she's a Lady Charles Barkley.
Jeremy with 16. Oh, Engler with a nice little give and go, scoring there.
Rollins isn't going away, Jack. Far from it.
12 points this half for Karma Jeremy. Engler now up to 13 points. The lead is 1.
Yes, shoe.
I tell you though, McClendon at 6-1 closes, and that makes the threes just not there. So Franson scoops it, blocked by McClendon, taken away. Rollins with a chance to lead. A pretty good Rollins contingent behind us, cheering their team on. Stone gives up her dribble. Gets it to Engler. Andrews, right elbow, tries to drive on Jeremy. Knocks her down. Airballed it, but into the hands of Engler. Shot clock running out and another
oh,
shot
wow.
clock violation.
How fortunate for the UT women. They give up 2 offensive rebounds, but luckily the shot clock never reset for Rollins.
Never hit the rim. And we are at the 5-minute timeout for the quarter. Tampa 50, Rollins 49, 5 minutes to go. You're watching this game on TampaSpartans.tv. University Dining Services by Sodexo allows you to choose from 27 dining stations. They serve breakfast, lunch, dinner, late night, and snacks. The official concession.
Hey,
I chose Rollins because the Spanish Mediterranean architecture is just beautiful. The weather's great. We're in central Florida. We're right on Lake Virginia, and I couldn't turn any of that down.
Rollins gave me that ability and that foundation that I needed to go into the world. And I think that I wouldn't have got that experience anywhere else.
Krispy Kreme has been serving delicious donuts and coffee. Visit our nearest Krispy Kreme on West Kennedy. Krispy Kreme serving hot donuts now. And the DoubleTree by Hilton Tampa Airport West Shore. Book a beautiful room or suite at our newly renovated Tampa DoubleTree Hotel on Cypress, just minutes from UT.
Here's a thought for you, Jack. A room at the DoubleTree with some Krispy Kreme donuts waiting.
There you go. Giving me any ideas like that.
Hey, I'd be honest, my favorite are the white cream filled.
Yeah. Tampa will inbound, holding on to a 1-point lead with half of this quarter to go. If you're a math major, that means an eighth of the game.
Rollins comes out in his zone.
Julia Ingram, tighter.
They need to set a shoe up for a shot.
McClendon out of the lineup, so that might give Ashew that space to get the three. Abney, 10 on the shot clock.
Tampa's just swinging it around the horn. You got to drive. You got to drive those gaps.
Ingram looks good.
And there it is, three by the freshman, her jersey number.
I tell you, that looked good all the way from here. We had the right in line with her.
It came by the dribble penetration and the ball movement. You got to move.
Just like you said, go inside and go out.
Yep.
They did. She hits. It's a 4-point lead.
Good defense.
Yeah, it was. Still gets shot up and in as Daniels. Point number six. The lead is two. 53-51. Ingram finds Warden to Ashew. They close on Ashew quickly. Tighter for three. No good. Daniels rebounds.
We got to get a stop.
Harrison between the rings. To Engler, guarded by Ashew.
Got to switch on screens with her.
They did, and Titer closed it out. Stone for three, no good. Warden pulls it down.
She shot that from deep, Jack.
It was. Maybe not what Glenn Wilkes wanted. Ashew just can't get a spot now.
No, they're on to her.
Yep. Ingram. Can
foul.
She? Oh, she'll go for three.
Almost a 4-point play.
She'd have brought everybody on the Spartan side of their feet had she knocked that one down.
I would have got up too.
Julia Ingram has only taken three free throws this year. Make it four now. Tom Jesse, when I talked to him before the game, said this time of year, she's not a freshman.
Not at all.
Pretty cool and calm out there.
Not at all. And one more shot for the trifecta.
Told my daughter that Julia played at Palm Harbor U, and she said, I want to meet her. Three for three. Looks good, huh?
Three huge free throws. Huge free throws. Wow. Big play by the freshman. Quick 6 points.
Lead goes five, and she's got six. 56-51. 3 minutes to go in the game. Long three. Engler, rattles it home.
She has no conscience, as I said.
She is 4 of 6 from deep. And 16 points.
She is tough. I think they got to face guard her, just deny her the ball.
Warden tries to run Harrison off some picks. Couldn't do it. 10 on the shot clock. Back to a man-to-man defense. 7 on the shot clock. Ashew looking for a pick. 3 on the shot clock. The tighter.
Got to get it up.
Pulls up on the jumper and knocks it down.
That's how it is. When you're struggling, keep shooting. You'll get out of it. Big
six
shot
for Titer.
Big shot. She's halfway to her average, just about.
Engler directs traffic from up top. The lead is four. Engler looking, fires. No good. Goes out of bounds. It'll be Tampa's ball.
Yeah, Engler is, she's cold-blooded.
She's 4 of 7 from deep, 5 of 10 from the floor today. Full court press. They get it to Titer.
Clear out. Give her room.
And they do, and she gets it across. Under 2 minutes to go in the game. Warden, top of the key. Harrison guarding her. Franson with the pick. Warden steps back. Franson tries to go inside, and it hit Jeremy's foot. And went out of bounds. Stone back into the lineup. Andrews out.
A bucket right here will put the pressure on UT.
1:38 to go. 4-point lead for Tampa.
Guard the 3-point line, Spartan women.
Here comes Harrison. Bounce pass to Daniels. Tries to drive on Jeremy. Can't find her spot, and Jeremy rebounds. Rebound number 9 for Karma.
Take your time, but stay aggressive, Spartan women.
Rachel Warden, capable ball handler, gets it to Jeremy. Daniels guarding her.
The middle is open.
Has a spot.
Yep.
Fouled on the drive. I think it may be a reach on McClendon.
Yes, it was. She must have heard me. I said the middle is open, and she took off.
You know, every time you have said what to do, they've done it immediately. They must have a little earpiece.
I'm calling plays.
Tom Jesse calls a play. They look over to you to see if it's confirmed. New shot clock as the clock now down to 1 minute left in the game. 24 on the shot clock.
Right. Time is not on Rollins' side right now.
Inside to Franson. Smartly kicks it out. Eschew has time. Airballed it. I think it's Spartan's ball, and it hit Stone.
Wow.
Did not hit the rim, so 14 still on the shot clock. 50 on the game clock.
Big break for the Tampa women.
Jeremy triggers the inbounds, gets it to Franson. Again, be aware, 10 now on the shot clock. Warden to Eschew.
She's going to have to put it up.
Turn around.
Oh!
Big shot by Emily Eschew.
And she's wearing that number 23. Everyone that wears that number better do something great.
Stone. Down 6, 25 seconds to go. Drives the lane. Kicks it out, throws it away.
Go, Warden.
Almost gets it. That may be a backcourt violation.
Yes, it is.
18.7 seconds to go. Tampa's ball and a 6-point lead. Of course, DeCarlo, I got to let you know, number 23 started with my all-time idol, Pistol Pete Maravich.
Okay.
He was 23 in college.
Yes, he was.
I had to wear 23 in high school. Foul by McClendon on Franson. Franson about a 75% free throw shooter.
Maybe Jordan wore 23 because of Pistol Pete.
I don't know. They're both from North Carolina, prepped in North Carolina.
Yep.
Yeah.
He may have been paying homage to him. Jordan is big on, you know, North Carolina players because even what was his name? NC State.
David Thompson.
Yeah,
yeah, what a player he was.
He was a big advocate for David Thompson.
This
also.
Gym roof is not tall enough to keep David Thompson in it. He had about a 48-inch vertical jump,
wow,
if I remember.
Played for the Denver Nuggets.
He was a high flyer. Won an NCAA title in 74.
Right. And was only, what, like about 6'3"?
6'3", 6'4".
Yeah.
But if you can jump 4 more feet, that puts your head at 10-4. Branson missing the front end.
She has to stay on the line. She backed up a little bit as she was shooting.
That was the fifth foul, so it's shooting. And that's what Rollins wanted to do, is see if they could turn it around.
Rollins is
going
to shoot a three. They have to shoot a three.
Well,
they don't have time.
It's a three-possession game. Timeout called. 61-54, a full timeout called by Glenn Wilkes. Men's game coming up. Both men's teams are dressed and ready, warming up off the court. We've got the men's game coming up at 4 on TampaSpartans.tv. And we do not need an overtime in the men's game because I have to hustle over to the baseball game after the men's basketball game. I've got 3 games today.
All sports Saturday. That's what it should be called for you.
Doubleheader softball going on right now against Warner. This will be a big win for the Spartans.
It would be fitting for Jeremy to get the rebound on this Rollins shot to give her a double-double.
Get her the double-double. And a foul called on Titer, I believe. Kind of pushed Engler out of the way to try to get to Stone. I don't know if Tom Jesse really wants fouls right now. Just let them run the ball. The more they take time to score. Rebound. Jeremy rebounded.
Wow.
There you go. Double-double. Again, she heard. She glanced over and said, oh, one more rebound? Okay.
She heard me. How fitting.
16 points, 10 rebounds in 39 minutes of play. Two Spartans have played all 40 minutes, Warden and Eshoo. Karma Jeremy went out for a minute in the first half.
When the Spartan women were starting to lose a grip on this game, Jeremy was like, give me that ball. And she took control of it, and she got the points in the paint. The
she had
points.
4 points at half and 7 rebounds. 62-54.
Yeah, the game ball definitely has to go to Karma Jeremy.
Second free throw. Looks good. Lauren Cody in to give Molly Franson a well-deserved round of applause as she leaves the game.
3.3 seconds left, and I would say this one is just about over, Jack.
A big second half for the Spartans, and they pick up the win. Final score, Tampa 63 and Rollins 54. Tampa wins it. Running their record now to 8-7 in the Sunshine State Conference, 15-7 overall. For the Rollins Tars, they fall to 11-10, 6-9 in conference play. Leading the way for Tampa, 18 points, 10 rebounds for Karma Jeremy. Emily Eshoo with 13, Molly Franson with 11, Rachel Warden with 6, along with 5 assists in the game. Stacia Titer with 6 as well. Abney with 3, Ingram with 6. Nice job by Julia Ingram off the bench for Tampa. On the other side, Stone with 4, Harrison 10, Engler with 16, McClendon with 4, Daniels with 6, and Leah off the bench hitting 4. The Spartans shot 45% for the game, 54% in the second half. As the Spartans pick up a win, and a big win at that, as that will keep them on top conference. Karma Jeremy, what a nice game you had today.
Thank you, appreciate that.
18 points, 10 rebounds.
Woo!
You had to get a rebound. DeCarlo said she needs one more rebound on the last shot for the double-double.
And I got it.
And you got it.
That's all I'm talking about. Way to call it.
You took over in the second half. It seemed like you just wanted to get in there and put the layups in and muscle your way through.
It's Rollins. There's nothing else I can say. It's Rollins. That's ultimate rivalry. It's the last time I'm going to see him on my floor. You know what I'm saying? Had to go out with a bang. Had to.
Two women on the Spartan team from Colonial, 2 on their team. You must have had a heck of a high school team.
Oh yeah, we were real good in high school. Definitely, we were definitely real good in high school. We never got a state championship. We always got choked up at the end, but we were real good. It's beautiful coming back playing against them.
And are you good friends with them? Now you've got the bragging rights?
Yeah,
when you
I'm good
home?
Friends with them. Our high school team is out here with the high school coach. Everyone's out here.
Okay, that's
yeah,
neat to
man.
See. So this team has kind of changed in the last 3 games. Molly's back in the lineup. It gets you away from trying to be a 5'8 post player, a 5'9 post player. You're much more effective with your game when you can look somebody in the eye as opposed to seeing a 6'3 player.
Oh, I 100% agree. But, I mean, I'm not going to lie. I got real accustomed to being down there because,
yeah.
You know, you've seen me play. See how many times those big guys have blocked me. But at the same time, I go around them just as many times, you know. But, yeah, it is good being able to get the ball on the wing, coming off screens, coming to my pull-up game, anything like that. Looking them in the eyes, that's right. My back not to the basket. You're right about that one.
You know, this is the team now. You're playing the way you did earlier in the season. You know, that skid there with Molly being hurt and everything, it was just tough on you guys. But you're playing like the team I think everybody expected now.
Oh, absolutely, absolutely. We just had to adjust to Molly not being out there because it's real different. We're used to being able to go into her, stretch the floor with her. But we really just had to figure out how to score, get some offensive efficiency with us. And we're working on it in practice. The more that we do what Coach says, and we're going to just go out and do what we want, we're winning. We're winning. It's going to keep happening.
All right. Three games in a row now for the Spartans. Now 8-7 in conference play. Working your way up the standings. Congratulations.
We got to see you there, man.
All right.
Thank you.
Nice job.
Thank you.
Karma Jeremy, 18 points, 10 rebounds, leads the Spartans to a victory today. A 63-54 win over the Rollins Tars, and a big win for the Spartans. Men's game coming up in a few minutes. DeCarlo, that's probably a sweaty headset now with Karma being over here.
I know, I'm used to it, though. It'll be all right.
All right, we've got a men's game coming up in about 30 minutes, and what are you expecting out of that game?
I'm going to tell you this. You know, a lot of opposing point guards have had good games against the Tampa men's basketball team. In fact, the last game, the only player in double figures for the St. Leo Monarchs was their starting point guard with 26. So we're going to have the lead. You know, the defensive efforts are going to have to come by, you know, keeping the other team's point guard at bay. And because the point is the head on both sides of the floor, so therefore the effort is going to be have a strong effort on both sides.
I was
from
told
the point guard
starting point guard will not be playing today for Rollins, so that may help the Spartans somewhat. We'll find out in about 30 minutes.
But sometimes the next man up is just as deadly.
I was told he's pretty good too.
Yeah. You know, you can't sleep if you relax because someone else isn't playing. Someone else may bite you.
Yeah.
So you can't relax.
Rollins comes in with a 10-4 mark in the men's game, leading the Sunshine State Conference. Big game coming up. We'll have it in about 30 minutes, so stick with us. For DeCarlo DeVoe, this is Jack Ike saying thanks for joining us. You've been watching this game on TampaSpartans.tv. Tampa women 63, Rollins 54.